Today is the day that we take down Phalao, but first let's see what the vendor sells us, shall we? Are you ready? Let's go! What up YouTube? Welcome to another Division 2 video. Thanks for clicking my content, really appreciate you watching it. If you like my content and want to help the channel out, don't forget to smash that like button. And let's start with the White House for this vendor reset. Zero F's Badgertov, of course, with the perfect Unbreakable on there. 130k armor, 3.7k armor regeneration and explosive resistance. Pretty decent one. Roll the explosive resistance away for whatever you think is necessary. You have a pretty decent Unbreakable. Over to the Black Market T821. Swap speed on there and steady handed. I'm not loving the swap speed on there and the SMG damage is very, very low. Arc, same. Accuracy almost maxed out, but look at that assault rifle damage. No, thank you. PX4 Storm, pistol, open world, never buy it. Backpack from Alps with 7% skill damage, 3.8k armor regeneration and Bloodsucker. I don't know if you like the combination of Bloodsucker, skill damage and or armor regeneration on here. RNK Vest with 8.1% hazard protection, 16.7% repair skills and Vanguard. Isn't that great if you ask me? I'm not loving the repair skills on there and the hazard protection. But this could be a decent combo if you want to go for a shield build with the Vanguard on there, repair skills, and then maybe something else for the hazard protection, but that's all you. Over to the mods, 4.3% critical hit chance, 6.3% duration for your drone, 5.9% skill haste for your turret, and 6.3% duration for your sticky launcher. But let's head over to the clan and see what they sell us this week. And there we are at the clan vendor, the backpack force multiplier, the named Hanayu with of course perfect combined arms on there is for sale here and it's a very, very nice one. 10.6% critical hit damage already on there and then 8.9% status effect. Roll a status effect away for some skill damage and you have a very, very nice backpack for your crit skill build. Knee pads from Asus, maxed out weapon damage, weapon handling on there. Roll the weapon handling away for something else and you have a maxed out Asus knee pads. Tip of the spear with only 6% weapon handling on there and a 12.6% weapon damage. If you're still looking for it, roll the weapon handling away and optimize the weapon damage. Hardwired, you know my opinion, it has a skill tier as the core attribute, always craft it, never buy it. Tactical UMP 45 could be a lot better if you ask me. Hunting M44, same, not great. Gloves from Golan with the 152k armor on there, 5% critical hit chance already, and roll the repair skills for whatever you think is necessary. Some armor regeneration, for example, in your very, very nice gloves. I think I'm gonna pick some up as well. Over to the custom L86. Could be a very nice one, but I'm not loving preservation on there. If you want to rock the LMG damage, damage your target out of cover, and the critical hit damage, roll the preservation away for whatever you think is necessary, and then optimize the rest. PP19 with a maxed out health damage, optimist on there, but the rest is too low in my opinion. The optimist could be nice, the health damage as well, but we're not doing that much health damage as long as we play against the higher tier enemies. Over to the Flak Jacket from Hanayu with 8.3% skill damage on there, 4.2k armor regeneration and Gunslinger. Not loving the Gunslinger on there and then the combination of armor regeneration, I will leave it here. Wyvern Vest with status effect, weapon handling and focus on there. Status effect could be nice, but I'm not loving the focus on there and the weapon handling. So this combination, I will leave it here. Over to the mods, 8.9% blind death resistance, pretty decent one. 6.4% skill haste for your turret, 9% effect duration for your pulse, pretty decent one as well. And then the 8.6% health for your drone. But let's head over to the theater and see what they sell us this week. And there we are at the theater. The artist tool is the first thing we can pick up. The named rifle with perfect rifleman on there. but the rest isn't that great. I would leave it here. KSG shotgun could be nice. Could be nice, but then the headshot damage on there. Close and personal is already on there, so that's nice for a shotgun. So roll, for example, damage you target out of cover over the headshot and optimize the rest. You have a pretty decent KSG shotgun. M16A2, not loving stability and vindictive as the combo on here. Keeler Guard with 120k armor, 15k health and 8.4% status effect on the gloves. Not loving the health and the status effect combination. Over to the knee pads from Araldi. Would love to see some other things weapon handling, because the rest is too low. You need to optimize it or roll it. It's gonna set you back a lot. Over to the mods. 8.5% shock resistance, 4.2% radius for your mine, 4.1% shield health for your shield, 5.9% blind effect duration for your firefly, and of course we got something for our decoy, and this time it's the 5.5% duration. But let's head over to the campus and see what they sell us this week. And there we are at the campus. The Akeem's long stick is the first thing we can pick up, named Markham's rifle with perfect range on there, but the rest is just trash. Please leave it here. SAR Plus SVD Future, perfect on there. Magazine size on the rest is too low to buy. Military MK46, Frenzy already on there, but the rest is again too low to buy. Roll the accuracy away for some damage to armor, for example, but then you have to optimize the rest. Then we go over to the 4.3% critical hit chance, 15.6% repair skills on the Mask of Wyvern. Roll the repair skills away for whatever you think is necessary. In my opinion, some skill damage. And again, you have a very nice mask for skill damage build or skill DPS build. Over to the Badger Tough, 170k armor, 6.9% explosive resistance and 7% skill damage. Not loving the explosive resistance and skill damage as the combo on this Badger Tough holster. Over to the mods, 9.9% skill haste, 13.6% in share health for your chem launcher, 4 extra stinger charges for your hive, 14% health for your pulse, and over to the 4.2% duration of your shock traps. But let's head over to the DZs and see what they sell us. And there we are at DZEs. The Carnage is the first thing we can pick up. Light machine gun, the named one with perfect status on there, but the rest is just trash if you ask me. Maybe you can roll the LMG damage to that max cap and optimize the damage to armor. You have a pretty decent one then, but I think it's too much for the 153 DZ credits. Paratrooper SVD, leave it here as well, way too expensive. Military M60, same, not loving the critical hit chance and the preservation on there. Mask from True Patriot with 10.4% critical hit damage already on there. Roll the armor to that max cap and you have a pretty decent True Patriot for your True Patriot crit build. Over to the Eclipse, you know the deal, always crafted, because this has a skill tier, you will always have it god rolled. Over to the 511, not loving the brand set at all, not doing it for you, so please leave it here. DNH holster with 12.9% weapon damage, but then only 6.2% headshot and 14.7% repair skills. Not loving the repair skills. Maybe you can roll it away for some crit chance or crit damage and optimize the rest, but it's gonna set you back. And then you know my opinion about the mods and the DZs, guys. Way too expensive to buy here. Go for the open world or go for the summit. Let's head over to our next DZ. And there we are, DZ South, and the Orbit is for sale. Yes guys, this handgun is pretty hard to get and only drops in the dark zones. The Orbit is of course the named pistol with perfect finisher on there, giving you that critical hit chance and critical hit damage when you take out an enemy, but it has very, very low rolls. You can pick it up if you didn't have the chance to get it out of the dark zone or never found it. Then roll at optimal range for damage to target out of cover, for example, and then optimize the pistol damage. It's gonna set you back a few bucks, but it's a very, very nice handgun to have. MP7, not great if you ask me. Military AKM, InSync already on there, so you could roll the accuracy away for some damage to target out of cover and optimize the rest. But again, it's gonna set you back. X45 pistol, go for the open world. Backpack from Hunter's Fury with 7.3% headshot damage on there. Would love to see something else because the 10.8% weapon damage is too low. Hunter's Fury, same. Would love to see something else for the status effect because it's gonna set you back when you need to optimize at 11.3% weapon damage. Over to the backpack from Empress International with 10.1% critical hit damage already on there, 8.4% status effect, but yeah, I'm not loving the combination again with calculated on there. Then we got the DNH Fast Mad Bomber is enough to see. Because the rest is trash as well. You do not want that weapon handling on there. And yeah, Mad Bomber, I don't understand why it's still a chest piece. But yeah, that's just my opinion. And then the mods, please leave them here. Go for the open world, go for the summit, or even buy them in the open world vendors. Let's head over to our last DZ. And there we are, last DZ, DZ West, and the backup boomstick is the first thing we can pick up. Of course, the named shotgun with that 17% shotgun damage on there. If you're still looking for it, you can pick it up, roll the critical hit damage for something else. Breadbasket on there isn't that great, but yeah, it's a decent shotgun, although it's the third gun to use, so if you don't have that much of DZ creds, just farm it and do not buy it at the vendor. 612 could be a lot better. Optimist on there is nice. Then roll maybe the magazine size away for some damage to target out of cover and optimize the rest, but it's gonna set you back. The rifle LFAO with the critical hit damage maxed out, but the rest is just trash. Over to the Striker with almost maxed out critical hit damage on there, 11.8% and only 5.8% weapon damage, but we can roll that. So if you're still looking for a very nice Striker gloves, roll the weapon damage to 15% and you only have to optimize 0.2% critical hit damage. Eclipse, you know the opinion, skill tier is the core attribute, always crafted. Walker and Harris could be a lot better, but could be decent as well. Status effect away for some critical hit chance or some headshot damage, whatever you think is necessary, and then optimize the rest. China Light could be better as well, but this could be something for your China Light crit build if you want to build one, because 4.1% critical hit chance already on there, and then the skill damage over that explosive resistance will save these knee pads. And then the last mods of the DZs, again, please go for the open world. Do not buy them here, they're way too expensive. Let's head over to New York and see what they sell us this week. And there we are, first vendor of New York. The PDR is the first thing we can pick up and has killer on there, but the rest is just trash if you ask me, too low to buy. The Negav, same. I won't love to see something else as that stability, the rest is pretty low. Black Market SCSG, nah, no thanks, just leave it here. M1911 from last week was very nice, but this one please leave here. Backpack from Gilligard with combined arms on there, arm regeneration, critical hit chance and armor. This could be a very nice backpack, and then roll the talent away for whatever you think is necessary and optimize the rest. Over to the knee pads from Alps. Not loving the repair skills and the armor regeneration as the combo. You can go for something else, for example, for the armor regeneration, because the first brand set bonus also gives you repair skills. Then over to the Wyvern, 4.5% critical hit chance and 9.9% skill haste. Very nice holster to buy as well. 4.5% critical hit chance already on there. Roll the skill haste for some skill damage. You have very nice holster for your skill DPS build. Over to the mods, 4.4% critical hit chance, 16.6% repair skills, 4.2% deflect damage for your shield, 6% skill haste for your firefly, and 6% health for your decoy. But let's head over to our last vendor of today. And there we are, Edroy, our last vendor of today. The enhanced PP19 is the first thing we can pick up, but it's not great. My opinion, just leave it here. M60, same. Unhinged on there could be nice. You could roll the critical hit damage for something else, damage to armor for example, and optimize the rest, but it's gonna set you back. KSG shotgun could be a nice one as well. Again, roll the steady handed away and optimize the rest. D50, pick it up if you still need your liberty or craft multiple liberties, else please leave it here. Armadillo vest from Gilaguard, of course, with the 5.5% critical hit chance on there, 130k armor, or almost 130k armor, 3.1k armor generation and reassigned. Again, a very, very nice vest to have for your crit Gilaguard build. Then roll the talent away for whatever you think is necessary and then optimize the rest. And then over to the Murakami glove, 16.7% repair skills and 8.4% status effect. Could be something. In my opinion, roll the skill damage over the status effect, you have a pretty decent Murakami gloves. Over to the Araldi, two yellows on there, could be something maybe for your skill damage build. Roll the skill haste for critical hit chance or critical hit damage, a pretty decent holster, but still not that great. Over to the last mods of today, guys, the 8.5% bleed resistance, 8.3% bleed resistance. I don't understand this again, but yeah, probably just me. Over to the next one, 5.7% duration for your turret, 8.3% stim efficiency for your hive, and at last the 4.9% blast radius for your sticky payload. But yeah guys, that's pretty much it for today. I know today is the day that we hunt down Feilau. I cannot wait to jump on. I have to fix some things at home first, so probably in around 2 to 3 hours I'm gonna jump on and definitely gonna show you what is going to happen at the end. Are we taking Fey down, or is there something else in the works? But for today, thanks for watching, hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to smash that like button and hit that subscribers button. And of course the notification bell. Pure Prime out.